All right, I am back. I am finished with my lunch, so I am back. I handled that. My good friend Mama Skit, who also has a channel on here, sent me some awesome new artwork for my page. My offline screen, my new header, and an emoji. So I just set all that up. Pretty exciting stuff. That was my break in a nutshell. So if you watched the last stream, the first hour before I took my lunch break, you will notice I'm in the exact spot I left off at. I have not touched the game at all. So, let's go.
There's only one way to Cinderbrick Fort. The hard way.
All right.
Sure, the city marshals may be gone, but now the fort's crawling with windbags. The calamity was mercy. They've been left to freeze, or starve, or face the kid.
Damn, he got me good on that one. Need a new potion. Well, another potion, not a new potion.
Well, windbags young and old keep fighting for the fort. At least the marshals left the kid a parting gift. Something the windbags just can't handle. Something that'll punch clean through their greasy hides. Windbags ain't much different than normal folks. All they want's a warm place to stay and a decent meal. A lot of them wound up here in this very fort. business underground like in the old days. The windbags put the kid on notice. Windbags can't use martial supplies, but the kid sure can. As for the windbags, Cinderbrick gave him enough heat and metal to munch on for a while. Well, the fort ain't theirs by right. Can't blame them for wanting it, though.
I can do that too, you son of a bitch.
So many of those sorry things hold up inside that old fort. He's blasting everything in sight with that newfangled musket. Good thing the windbags don't know kid's fresh out of health tonics. Security is plain gone haywire. Windbags gummed up the works. Afraid to get burned. Trap the kid in the middle of the force parade grounds. Then they bring out Brutus and Glandon, all their scumbag uncles. They got something to gain, and only their sorry hides to lose.
Make these fuckers kill each other.
The kid takes down Glutus. Or maybe it was Landon. The other big fella soon joins his brother. Wherever they are now. Kid used to dream of getting a Marshal's badge, but not like this. The Skyway's a welcome sight after all that. And now ain't nothing left for nobody down at Cinderbrick Fort. Kid shows up just as Ulf's telling me about his own journey to the city. Seems the only thing the Calamity saved for Ulf was a smoking pipe. Poor kid collapses after just one drag. The past. Only good thing ever come out of the past is history. Catches up with the kid. Hardly had a moment's rest since all this started.
What the fuck?
Fair to say he's led a hard life. Supposing what he says in his sleep ain't no lie. He never knew his old man, but he had his mama to take care of. Frail thing with pure white hair like his. What was I saying? Anyway. Having his mama's hair did the kid no favors while he was growing up. But he learned to hold his own out there. school ain't working out, so the kid signs up for a turn on the rippling walls. Make his mama some money. Thanks to folks like the kid, the walls kept Ceylandia safe from whatever's out there. The elements, the Ura, you name it. Once the kid done his time, he hurried on home. Turns out his mama's time was done too. The city had nothing for him. The money he'd been sending home was nowhere to be found, either. So what'd the kid do? Why, he went right on back to the walls for another 5 years. Wait, where was I? In the history of Ceylandia, nobody has ever volunteered for a second shift on the walls. Out there, a kid learned to fend for himself. Learn to build, learn to break. In time, the kid earned good standing with the marshals. They trusted him to scout out farther than anybody. One night, on one of his expeditions, the ground beneath him shuddered, cracked, and split apart. You saw nothing where the world used to be. The calamity happened just like that. All the kid had to work with was his hammer and the clothes on his back. Twisted streets, he ran with nothing but the city crest and an old stranger's voice to guide him. Maybe now's not the time. Finally arrived at Ceylandia's vaunted safe haven. He and no one else. Well, what does it matter?
I'm just gonna get my ass whooped repeatedly.
But then, all he got was more thankless work from a man who ain't even asked his name. Sure, I may be the one who dreamt up the walls and the bastion, but the kid made him real, not me. I'd like to say I'll never forget him, or what he's doing, what he's done. I surely would. The marshals seem like good men, he says. They treated him with dignity. Zolf brought his antique smoking pipe all the way from the terminals.
Huh? I ain't falling for that again.
Even since the Urus surrendered to us, the Marshals kept a wary eye on him. Zolf's travels ain't much compared to what the kids had to go through for all this. The memorial. Here a kid can pay respect to the old world and earn it in kind. The valediction. Just another one of my sketches. Nothing more. Words can't express what happened, but they're all I got. You want to tune a scrap musket, you start with the barrel.
I just realized I was muted. Luckily, I don't think I said much of anything, so that's good. After this level, I'm gonna take a quick bathroom break.
The Langston River flowed free and wild till the Calamity drank it all up. Maybe all that water just grew wings and flew off. Riverbanks swarming with windbags. They're so bent on finding the core, they hardly notice the kid. Lucky for him, a certain famous ferry barge is still afloat. Weepin' Nelly. She sends some squirts crying home as she leaves port. Maybe Nelly knows the way to the core. Maybe she can slip right past all the clamor on the coast. Or maybe not. A security skiff pulls up portside. Nelly's just another windbag to those guns. Just then, the windbags notice who she's sailing with. They're pretty steamed about what happened at Cinderbrae. try to cut her off. They try to slow her down. They try to knock her out. Well, Weepin' Nelly tries harder. Try as she might, though, she hits a snag. Kids gotta help her get untangled. Favors for favors. She picked a good spot for a break, because the core is right there. Then the kid hears an unusual sound, like 100 flapping wings. They had their own eyes on the core. But why? Well, kid ain't got time to think it over just yet. Finds Weepin' Nelly raring to go. Turns out she's got a special surprise for when the waters get rough. She's gonna need a little help with all them pickers. Crafty things think they're king of the roost now. Rest of us only wish we were flying in times like these. Security's gifts keep on coming, starboard side. Don't seem to care what they shoot, as long as they hit something. Kid almost falls again. Windbags get an even better idea. They aim to smash with the Nelly splinters. Just trying to help. Maybe they don't care. Well, it all proves too much for poor Nelly. She's just gotta make one last stop. With her last breath, Nelly gets the kid to solid ground. Solid ground in picker country. Seems a calamity ain't hurt the peckers' appetites. They want that core real bad. Might be they want it just as bad as a kid.
He's fucking impossible.
He takes a hard hit, but he ain't finished. Kid shoos him off, knowing they'll be back. Know how many times kid nearly fell off the barge back there? 5 times. Now, listen close. You should remember this next part.
Hey, Dr. MF Tran, what's up, man? Thanks for gifting subs.
Used to take an enterprising man or a plain old fool to venture out that far.
So I set an emote, well, emoji, emote, whatever you want to call it, of the TD bomb, my little logo thing, for tier one subs. Is it there for you? Because on mine, I'm not subscribed to my, it doesn't let me use it, so.
But on the other hand, some folks just yearn to see the things they're told they can. And that's why you go to Prosper Bluff, ain't it? There, the kid hears something he ain't heard in a long while. How's it go again? Yeah, that's the one.
Okay, I don't know why it's not on there yet. It might have to be approved or something. I have no clue. But yeah, it's on the Discord, so that's cool. At least it's somewhere. I'll figure it out. I'm sure Jess knows the answer. I can talk to her about it later.
Sorry to interrupt.
My home.
explaining what happens next, right? Suffice it to say, kid ain't coming home empty-handed. And besides, it's like the song goes.
Gonna build that city on a hill.
They'll be here before too long.
Yeah. Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if it needs approval as well, so.
We darn near celebrated when the kid got back, didn't we? Zolf never thought he'd see a fellow her again. We become fast friends. Calamity has that effect on people. But there was more to be done. There was one last core to find. Kid surprised when I tell him there's only one core left. I shouldn't have believed it either. If only I'd known half the secrets of the Calamity were tucked away in that book, I'd have worked to translate it right away. A scientific journal written in Zolf's native tongue. He learned so much from it. Too much. Behold, the Pantheon.
All right, I'm going to take a quick bathroom break, and I will be right back.